Hi, today we'll demonstrate the full workflow of a METS ingestion from preparing the METS package to depositing it in Rosetta. First, let's take a look at the content we're going to ingest. In this example, it will be several image files, which we wish to store in Rosetta as one IE with two reps, the first rep being a preservation master and the second being a modified master. Under this directory, Europe Images, our data has to be organized according to the METS structure. We're now on the SIP level. There must be a folder called Content, and optionally a dc.xml file with the SIP title. Now let's look at the Content folder. We are now on the IE level. Here we have at least one IE.xml file. But we can have more if we wish to ingest several IEs under this SIP. We also have the Streams folder, which contains the actual media files we want to ingest. Alternatively, the files could be placed in a different location, in which case the IE.xml file would specify the full path where they can be found. Now let's look at our IE.xml file. The file describes one IE, and is divided into several sections. The IE-DMD section contains the IE's descriptive metadata, or DMD for short, such as title and description. The IE-AMD section contains the IE's administrative metadata, or AMD for short, such as entity type and access rights policy. Next, we have the representation's administrative metadata. In our case, we have two reps, one preservation master and one modified master. Then we optionally have the file's administrative metadata, such as label or fixity. We could also have a section for the file's descriptive metadata. Finally, we have the file section, which puts it all together, defining the hierarchy of the IE. In our case, the first rep contains two files, and the second contains one file. It is here that the file name or location is specified. The IE.xml file can also contain a struct map section used for the delivery of complex IEs. So now we have our IE.xml file ready, in the content folder, in our SIP package. The next step is to put it in a mount folder where Rosetta can access it. So let's open our FTP client and drop our SIP package in the mount folder. The mount path is known to Rosetta, as we shall soon see. We are now ready to deposit the SIP, but since this is our first deposit in Rosetta, we need to make a few configurations beforehand in the Rosetta Management module. First, let's take a look at our METS material flow under Deposits, Material Flows. The Rosetta METS deposit is an out-of-the-box automated material flow. Note that our content structure is METS, which is necessary for our METS deposit, and our submission format is internal.nfs. We can update this submission format to fit the specifics of our deposit workflow, as we're about to do. So under Deposits, Submission Format, let's update internal.nfs. Crucially, this is where you provide the path of your mount, where we just placed the SIP. Now for the deposit itself. In this demo, we will make a manual deposit using the METS material flow, but normally the deposit is done automatically by a submission job that runs regularly and checks if there are new SIP folders under our mount. So, to make the manual deposit, go to Home, Add Deposit Activity, and in the Deposit module, click Add Deposit Activity. Now, select Rosetta METS Deposit, which is the material flow we've just seen. Next. Now let's select the folder of our deposit. Next. And finally, submit deposit. To view our deposited material, let's go to the Submitted tab, grab our SIP ID, And back at the management module, under submissions, search for the SIP ID. Here's our SIP. Let's show it in the assessor workbench. Click Work On. This is the IE of our SIP. Let's see its structure. And here indeed, we can see our IE has two reps, preservation and modified masters. And each rep has its assigned files. And under View Object, we can see our pictures. Thanks for joining.